There we are, dueling. Now, why would you resupply your enemies with bullets when they'd run out of them? Just how crazy is that?
Silly,
or indeed a plastic spoon.
Unless they were...
Keep it fair.
Fake
no,
bullets.
No, real bullets.
Real bullets.
There's your enemy, you desperately want to defeat them. They're running out of ammunition, and you resupply them.
Are they bullets which explode when
sabotage?
You...
Sabotage?
No.
Are they somehow sabotage?
Has somebody else come
no.
to attack us?
They're good bullets. No, no, you deal, you make a deal with it.
It's fair.
A sense of honour.
Fair play.
It's something so wonderful, I think, that should guide the British government in its policy on a particular issue, one that's very dear to me and the nation who have this marvellous building that I've had trouble pronouncing sometimes. It's in the Acropolis.
Ah, yes.
That's where the Parthenon is.
Parthenon.
Yes,
yes,
yeah. And it's that. The Parthenon yes. we're discussing. So, Greece, let's go back almost 200 years.
Right.
Who ran Greece 200 years ago?
Turks.
Turks, the Ottoman Empire. And there was a big movement to free Greece, led by Greeks, but also by some Britons, notably Lord Byron,
yeah.
who died there. And by 1820, they'd got quite a grip on the colonialists, and they'd pushed them all back up the Acropolis. And there they were in the Parthenon, that wonderful building. And the Turks were firing, and they ran out of shot. Now, the original builders of the Acropolis were extraordinary architects. And they joined together these 70,000 pieces of marble in a magnificent way. They put in sheets of lead to protect it and the bits of iron staple and lead to keep connecting together the marble. But then, in 1820, when the Ottomans were defending it, they started to use these lead sheets to melt them down to make shot. And the Greeks said, we're not going to have that happen to the Parthenon.
Ah, so you give them bullets to stop them doing
it? They gave them bullets to stop them destroying the building they loved so much that meant Athens to them. And if that story doesn't make the British government get off its arse and give back the Elgin marbles, I don't know what will.
Do we, if we do that, do we have to give back everything else
no,
as well?
No,
because we've got lots of stuff, haven't we?
No, that's the slippery slope fallacy. It's the first fallacy of logic, and it just doesn't play. Anyway, yes, that's basically it. I didn't give you much of a chance to come in on that, did I? But it's a good story. I
well,
thought it was
I
worth
like
telling.
When you're passionate on a subject.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
But isn't it a wonderful story about human beings that even in the face of death that we revere beauty and great art
completely.
More than ourselves. I think that's marvellous.
It is wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I agree. Right.